Today I'm going to show you how to play Herbie Hanckocks' smash hit Watemelon Man on rhythm guitar. Hi, my dear jazz guitar friends all over the world, Sandra Sherman here. Greetings from Austria. Some people have a hard time figuring out how to adopt Herbie Hanckocks' iconic piano riff of Watemelon Man onto the guitar. So I'm here to help. I use a little trick for that, actually. You learn the rhythm part with all the guitar chords, note for note, slow and easy, and there's also a slow tempo version towards the end of this lesson. I've made tabs and backing tracks, including a slightly altered version due to copyright reasons. The links to all this fun is down below in the description box. Please read the download instructions right to those links. And now let's start grooving. Are of course in the original key of F, and we have 4 bars of intro. Actually, there are 8 bars of intro, but I shorten it so it's not that boring, and a 16 bars head. All right, let's get started. All right, I use a drop D tuning for the entire song. What does that mean? That means we tune the E string down to D. 2 semitones. So your tuner shows E, then tune it down to E flat, turn more until it reaches D. The D string and the E string should now sound alike, but the E string is 1 octave lower. All right. Now for the intro, we have 1 bar that is being repeated 8 times in the original version and 4 times in my shorted version. All right. And why do I use a drop tuning at all? Because I have an F7 in the intro here, and I cannot reach over to that F. I want that bass to keep ringing, all right? So when I drop tune it, I have my F here where the G was. Now it's an F. I bar over this, then the D string also on the 3rd fret, 4 and 4 of G and B, right? Those 4. That sounds very wrong now, but that's because we hammer with our pinky to the 5th fret of the G string. That's the C, and that's the 5 of the F7 chord. And now it makes sense. That's a quick hammer. It's not, it's. Then I play the A string. That's the C, which is the 5th of the chord. Now I lift all my fingers, those fingers off, and I get the 3rd, 3rd of 3rd, and 3rd of these 3 strings, D, G, and B. That's a B flat chord, actually. I play it twice. You can leave your index barred over. Right? And that's about it. Then I have a bass again. And the beginning bass again, so 2 more bass notes. All right, here are the first 8 bars of the verse, and that's phrase number 1. We start the same way we did as the intro, but now we don't go to the A string, but directly to the B flat. 3, 3, 3 of D, G, and B string, twice. And then we start all over again, 4 times, all right? 3, 4. then we go to the fourth degree, because this is basically a blues in F. So first degree F, fourth degree B flat. Here's B flat, first fret of the A string, plus an B flat triad after that, B flat, D, and F. 3-3-1. So bass first, rest follows. Then the in-between chord is again, lift your fingers off like we did in the F thing. Now we have an F minor. Upper three strings on the first fret by barring. Twice, being played twice. Then you go to the F bass with your ring finger, that's the third fret of the E string, and you play that bar again. So that's for the B flat, twice. Sorry, wrong string. The last F I would play with my index, because we now go back to the F, to the one chord. You play the same thing as the first four bars, but only two bars, and you don't play the last F, the last third fret, because we have the C coming up being anticipated. Just up until here. Let me play the entire eight bars for you at slow tempo now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it's for the five chord of the blues, and that's a C in the key of F, and we move up here to C altered, actually, without the bass note. Just the 8-9-9 of D, G, and B strings. That comes from the C altered. I cannot play the bass because we're tuned in drop D, so, and actually I don't need it. So this is all we play. I would fret it like this, because next I exchange the sharp 5 for the regular 5, and that's moving from 9th fret to 8th fret. That's a C7, comes from this chord, right? C7 sharp 5 to C7. Then we want to go over to the B flat chord, which is 2 frets to the left, and in between Herbie plays a B7. Transition. So B flat. The same thing, just one down and another one down. Now we move the same thing up again via the B and back to the C. We repeat that twice. So it's not a 12 bar blues, it's a 16 bar blues where the 5 and 4 chords are repeated. All right. One more time, repeat it. And now we stop on a B flat. That's a shot or a kick. And it's on the one, on beat one. And 1, 2, 3, 4 is rest. And then we have that intro again with that fifth in bass. So this time with the A in bass too. For two bars. All right. So let me repeat the entire phrase number two for you at slow tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. You may also want to check out my jazz blues tutorials I have up here on my YouTube station. If you like this video, please give it a fat thumbs up. Don't forget to share the love and subscribe my channel so you never miss anything. I see you next week. Servus, baba.